Hey, it's Adrenium, and welcome back to another Minecraft Vehicles video. In this video, I'm going to showcase 10 train designs from steam engines to modern day trains. I found inspiration from real life trains, but I've not directly remade them in Minecraft. If you want that, I would highly recommend Crafty Foxe's YouTube channel. Link is in the description. But let's start off with the first design, a smaller steam engine. I wanted these designs to be relatively simple, but still convey some detail. A good color scheme for this type of train is gray, as there are a lot of slabs and stair variety in this color. Trains, from for example Wild West movies, were also quite often grayscaled. So that's why I chose the color for this first design. So the train carriages are pretty simple. I just use some spruce wood and some spruce trapdoors on the outside to give it more detail and to stand out a bit more. On the roof, I both use andesite, cut andesite and cobblestone to give it some more texture. And the carriages themselves are pretty small. They're only 5 blocks wide and only 3 windows, but I think it works for a train this small. The second design is the bigger of the two steam trains. Only one of the 10 trains is 4 blocks wide instead of 5, but you can still make trains bigger by making it taller and bulkier. That is what I've done with this train design. And instead of using a grey color scheme, I've used a mixture of netherrack and other red blocks. But I think it works out very nicely because we have nether brick slabs at our disposal. On this train, I've only built 2 carriages, one for passengers and one in the back, which I don't really know the purpose of, but I've seen it in quite a lot of trains. The carriage is much longer than the train before, as this train is much bigger and can pull a much heavier load. It's a more realistic carriage with much more space for the passengers. You would always add a bunch of these carriages together to make the train longer, but this is just for showcase. Even though the main part of the train is just a long square, it still looks round because I detailed it with slabs on the outside, and that conveys some sort of curvature. Otherwise, I've just used the netherrack and the red nether bricks to make some texture on the train. And I think this is a very good color scheme, kind of like the Hogwarts Express. But this particular train doesn't really look like the Hogwarts Express at all. I made these 10 trains from going to the oldest to the newest. This next train is an old cargo train, and I only saw one reference picture of it, but I think it looks very good, especially because there's so much detail on it. It is mirrored, so the front side and the back side are exactly the same, and they go down to the sides. On top, I used stone bricks to make the slope, and on the sides, I actually used trapdoors, which is also curved down, but at a slightly lesser angle. This is the only green train designs, and I actually also threw some melons in the color scheme. I think it works really well with the orange. The acacia wood is supposed to be rust, as to convey that this is an old train, but also because that was what I saw in the reference image, and I think it looks very good. The train carriages are quite simple. I used acacia strip logs and red sandstone walls, as you can see, and they look like containers quite a lot. I also threw in some acacia trapdoors at the top of the bottom to add more detail. On these trains, I tried to get as much detail on the wheels as possible. On this design, I used some item frames with normal hardened clay in and with some signs at the top. It's pretty hard to add detail without making it too detailed, as you have to have a shape that stands out from the rest so you can actually see what shape the train is. This next design I actually first built in my abandoned city for the train tracks. I then made a copy of that world, used World Edit to copy it over to this world, and then added some more details and made it a bit better. It's a very bulky passenger train, and I really tried to make the train itself and the carriages in the same style, and I think I've accomplished this. This train is also symmetrical from the front and the back, so it can drive both directions. The reference images I saw of this kind of train also were symmetrical from the front end and the back end, so I also made that here. The wheels are pretty simple, just a standard design with some coal blocks with buttons and a hopper in between. I've used this design on almost every train, and I think it works out fine. I actually also used some diorite in between some quartz to make it look a little more run down than the newer trains. You could maybe also use this as a freight train, but here I decided to use it as a passenger train. This is the last cargo train I will show you, but it's also a very classic interpretation of a freight train. I, for example, found inspiration for this train from GTA 5. I made the diagonal lines with quartz stairs and then some blue blocks behind. And even though the line isn't perfectly depending on where you are standing, like you have to be head on to get the full effect, I still think it looks kind of cool. I also tried to put a lot of detail on this train, but it's a bit hard since it's a mainly flat design on the sides. But as I said, I made some stripes and I also used some birch fences to break up the flatness. The guardrail on the sides are actually sticking out from the train, but since they only go a half block out, I think it's manageable. The wheels are very standard like the first design, and I also tried to mix up the blue color and the white color with a mixture of some concrete and concrete powder. You can also see where I put some buttons and some tripwire hooks, again for more detail. If you want to copy these trains block by block, it can be a bit hard if you only have the video to look at, so I will provide a world download in the description. Next up we have a passenger train. It could both be used as a metro train or it could be used above ground. I just found some reference images and a lot of them had one window to the side where the conductor was sitting. So on the left I have some glass and on the right I have some quartz stairs to indicate this. There's green strap going all the way around the train and all the windows are not actually done with glass. I've used quartz stairs and quartz slabs to make the windows stand out a bit more. The roof isn't that interesting, it is just made with some grayscaled blocks. On the inside I actually have a half block floor and that means I can use some lapis lazuli blocks and some birch trapdoors for the seats. Next up we have a metro train design and this is the only train which is 4 blocks wide. I don't really think a 4 block wide train design works in most cases. I'd much prefer 5 blocks wide with things sticking out, so maybe 7 blocks wide. But if a train's width is even, then the tracks also need to be even. And you can see it's not really the best track. I've just used some stairs and some spruce slabs for this to work. On this train design, the windows are actually made of glass, funnily enough, because the whole train was white and I didn't really need to define the windows here. So here I used a mixture of light gray and black stained glass. And the black glass is actually to define the window panes a bit more, but not in the same way as I did before. I've chosen to showcase these two next designs side by side as it's exactly the same design, but I just want to showcase how a different color really can make the train look different. On the left we have a yellow, green, white color scheme, and on the right I have a red, blue, white color scheme. This train is mirrored like the other passenger trains before it, so the conductor can both sit at the front and the back depending on which direction it is going. There also is a slight difference. On the yellow, white and green train, I have only used the green color at the bottom where the red nether bricks are on the red, blue and white train. Whereas on the red, blue and white train, I've also placed some blue powdered concrete at the bottom white row. So overall, it gets a bit darker in the color. I actually think that dark prismarine looks very cool on trains. It's a dark color, but it still gives off some color. So, and it complements this train design particularly very well. The train tracks are also a bit different to indicate that the blue and red train are a bit older than the yellow and green train. I also think that more vibrant colors indicate a newer train, whereas the darker color can look a bit old and worn down. The last train is also the most modern one, and you can see at the front I used prismarine stairs and slabs to make a very nice curve. You can also see the front window is very big, as I've seen on a lot of modern trains. And on the sides, it's white, but with orange patterns to break it up. In between the two trains, I've also used some prismarine blocks to indicate that here is where they separate. You can also add middle modules and extend it as far as you want. Actually, you could do this with every train you've seen so far. You could also just make more wagons. The only thing you need to do is have a front module on the front and a back module at the back. It's pretty simple. On the top, I've used some anvils and some hoppers to make the mechanism that takes electricity out of the wires above the tracks. I don't know what these are called on English or even in Danish. I have no idea what they call it, and I don't care to look it up. So I think you know what it is, because you've probably seen it everywhere on a lot of trains which are electrical. But that was really it for this vehicle's video. You could actually expect some of these train designs to be placed into my abandoned city, and you have already seen two of these designs. I don't know if I'll put more of these train designs into my abandoned city, as I already have two of them. But you never know. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye bye.